Is this a topic we want to go with 110%? I do not know. But what I do know is that there are some very interesting talking points about both of the players we're discussing in this video. Let's go over the Porin Assat. It is a team in Finland that is playing their Finnish Liiga hockey games. And it's the team that houses two prospects that we're going to be discussing today. First off, Jesperi Kotkaniemi from the Montreal Canadiens. This guy finally scored a point. It only took five games, yes. It took four games of nothing. But he's finally on the board. And we're also talking today about Roni Hirvonen, who is one of the Toronto Maple Leafs' recent pickups from that 2020 NHL Entry Draft. Now, we'll start off first with Hirvonen, because I wanted to get over this first. He's one of the more interesting guys in this conversation, because he's 18 years old. He was drafted 59th overall by the Toronto Maple Leafs at the 2020 NHL Entry Draft. If you read the scouting report over here, the 5'9", 170-pound center is dutiful in the defensive zone, maintaining an elevated work rate and putting on a clinic in body leverage going into puck retrievals. He does a fantastic job of anticipating plays, closing passing and shooting lanes, and making defensive switches on the cycle. He moves the puck with pace and regularly finds teammates with high danger passes. He was a guy who played with the Porin Assat last year, getting 16 points in 52 games played, but this year he's up there at 5 points in 13 games. However, the fact is, Jesperi Kotkaniemi, the Montreal Canadiens' third overall pick from 2018 and a very nice player in the playoffs, ended up joining the Assat too. And after Kotkaniemi made his arrival, Roni Hirvonen's ice time kind of dipped down a little bit. Now, earlier on in the season, he was playing a little bit more with the top guys, getting a little bit more minutes out there, but Kotkaniemi's arrival pushed him down there on the depth chart. However, in the most recent game where the Porin Assat played against JYP Jyväskylä, it was a 3-2 shootout win, Jesperi Kotkaniemi ended up getting an assist. He took a shot, it was blocked out in front, and his teammate put the puck in on the rebound. He's got 1 point, 1 assist in 5 total games played. That's really not great on paper, but we did talk about this earlier. Jesperi Kotkaniemi has not really been playing with the best line mates out there earlier on in his 5-game stint. There were shifts where he was out there, he was doing some magic, but the guy who received the puck on the other end just missed an open chance or whatever. He just shot it wide, something like that. There were some very good opportunities that should have been goals, that should have gave Kotkaniemi an assist or two before this point. But the fact is, on paper, he was scoreless, which is not good, and in fact, it's even more misleading towards being worse than it actually is, but Kotkaniemi is now up there at 1 point in 5 games played. However, the big thing that I've been seeing lately is the fact that Roni Hirvonen, Toronto Maple Leafs forward prospect, indeed has been outscoring Kotkaniemi in this stat. Take a look at this. This is from Leafs Prospect Update on Twitter. These are the stats of the two players since Kotkaniemi joined Porin. Hirvonen has 2 goals, 15 shots, and a 13.3 shooting percentage with 12 minutes of time on ice per game. Kotkaniemi is out here with 1 assist, 25 shots, in 1938. You can see that Kotkaniemi has been played more, in general, but the goal scoring, all that stuff, it is in the favor of Roni Hirvonen, the second round pick of the Leafs. It really is something that I think a lot of people are taking out of context and using it to say, okay, one player is better than the other, and it's definitive this way. Because if you take what would have been the actual realistic outcome for Kotkaniemi playing as the Porin Assat's number one power play guy, as the number one center, and as a guy who probably had some better line mates, I have no doubt that in a best case scenario, if you play those 5 games twice or 3 times over, Kotkaniemi would have had a lot more assists and points than just one. Who knows if he would have scored a goal? He has quite a few shots on goal. He's been taking a few shots. Even the most recent game saw him get 6 shots on goal. But Kotkaniemi's puck luck in terms of producing points has not been there. You can even see it from the recent game. He had 22 out of 26 passes completed. He was 7 for 11 on faceoffs. That's a pretty good number right there. 7 out of 11, 7-11. He's a guy who has been performing well in terms of all the other categories except for goals and assists. And I don't want to use one metric of point production or goals or whatever to definitively say anything about how a second round guy in 2020 is a better hockey player than what was a top pick in 2018's draft. Even if Jesperi Kotkaniemi was not taken third, he would have been taken fifth by Arizona because they were looking for a center too. And even if you take out those two teams and say, okay, that's just circumstantial evidence, these two teams wanted centers, so what if you just balance it out in general? Jesperi Kotkaniemi was still seen by many people to at least being a top 17 talent in the draft. Some, like McKean's and future considerations, had him at 13. TSN and Bob McKenzie, they had him at 5. Now, I will say, Bob McKenzie does take a look at the consolidated hearsay, I guess is the best word to use in this context, from NHL scouts, so that number is kind of skewed towards the direction of what NHL people believed would have happened. But Jesperi Kotkaniemi was a guy who would have been taken in this range regardless. I know everybody loves to crap on Kotkaniemi, and everybody did that in the most previous video, too. I spoke about how he was playing well, but he just hasn't been getting the luck to get the points going in. And a lot of you brought up some great points in the comments, you know? If he is as good as you're saying, Lego, how has he not at least potted in one? And I just want to make it clear that sometimes you can go through these really bad stretches. You can go through really huge, major inconsistencies that don't reflect statistically in how you're actually performing. And I don't want to make it seem like, oh, I'm really stretching the case out here for Kotkaniemi and making a defense for him, but at the end of the day, we have more to see from this guy. He's 20 years old, for crying out loud. Sure, Roni Hirvonen may just become the next Wayne Gretzky and overtake everybody. Not just Kotkaniemi, but everybody who was taken ahead of him at the 2020 draft. It's unlikely, but I will say, if that does happen, then great. Roni Hirvonen, a big steal for the Toronto Maple Leafs. You guys got yourselves a gem in the second round of 2020. I'm pretty much a huge fan of what Kyle Dubas did for the Leafs in 2020's draft, because almost all the Toronto picks, my gosh, huge upside, huge swings. I loved what they did. But for Hirvonen versus Kotkaniemi, you know, if you put these two in the NHL today, I think Kotkaniemi gets more points. I think Kotkaniemi looks more comfortable. I think Kotkaniemi looks better. And I know some of you are going to be like, yeah, duh, of course. He's 2 years older than Hirvonen, man. What are you talking about? But like, you know the argument I'm trying to make here, right? Just because the sample size indicates that even though these two have been on the same team for an extended amount of time and Hirvonen has outscored the guy, it doesn't mean, in my opinion, that definitively Hirvonen is more valuable. It's just one's been a little bit hotter than the other. So at the end of the day, talk to me in the comments what you think about Roni Hirvonen and Jesperi Kotkaniemi as well. I'm very much looking forward to it, honestly. Like, these arguments, and I'm using the word arguments because that's what it always goes down to whenever Kotkaniemi is mentioned in the video, they get so out of hand and everybody's really just clashing out on all sides. One side is saying, this guy's still young, he's got room to develop, he's gonna be okay. The other side saying, man, this guy's a bust, you could have had Hughes or Zadina, man. And you know, I think every Canadiens fan kind of knows that. Yes, you could have had Quinn Hughes. Yes, you could have had Filip, Zadina. Yes, you could have had players who have made better impacts quicker than Jesperi Kotkaniemi at the NHL level, but at the end of the day, this is who you have in your system, this is who you have to work with, this is who you're watching and who you're cheering for, and at the end of the day, Kotkaniemi has been fine. It's just he has not been producing, with a huge portion of that being bad luck. I know it's like, okay, how much defending can you do for him, Lego, but if this is the 1 out of 50 chance that Kotkaniemi does not go over and produce, then I'm willing to make that bet, because not every good player is good 100% of the time, statistically speaking. Players can play well without producing points, so yeah, at the end of the day, Roni Hirvonen, awesome, man. It's amazing what this guy has been doing, but I still do believe in Kotkaniemi. I still believe this guy's going to be good. I still believe this guy can produce points at the NHL level, let alone the Finnish Liga level, so we'll see where that goes from there, but you know, I'm going to take a lot of this back, because Roni Hirvonen, you know, even though he is not the guy who I'm saying that people are saying he is, where he is better than Kotkaniemi just because he's getting more points, hey, might as well give my props here too, why don't I? Because I know this whole speech may have pissed off a few Leafs fans. At the end of the day, Roni Hirvonen is great. As I said, Amirov, love that pick. Roni Hirvonen, love that pick. William Villeneuve, eh, you could debate whether or not he's going to make the league or not, but man, this guy has some big upside if you're able to fix the issues that he does indeed have. The Leafs, at 2020's draft, did a very good job taking a look at high upside picks, and they did that. Topi Niemelä is a nice pick. Dmitry Ovchinnikov in the fifth round, I really liked. Viti Mietinen, you guys went and you stole. So Roni Hirvonen follows that trend of nice, high upside players that you got at pretty much a discounted price, because a lot of these players, like, I'm not sure I would have projected them to be available in their spots, but hey, you know, at the end of the day, the Leafs did their thing. So Roni Hirvonen, definitely a very interesting prospect to take a look at. He is only 5'9", so he is not the biggest guy in the world, but a guy who was playing in the Finnish Liga full-time last year certainly does have some merit, and the fact that he is outscoring Kotkaniemi, while not being the complete verdict in my opinion, still is a noteworthy stat, which kind of makes a lot of Leafs fans excited, because hey, of course it does. So talk to me in the comments again what you think about both of these guys. Jesperi Kotkaniemi finally has a point. Roni Hirvonen has been doing his thing. He's outscoring Kotkaniemi. Hope you enjoyed this video with Trolls and I9. And bye.